Welcome to the official Jumpstart tutorial guide for Firstlight by FiLMiC, the pro photo app with analog vibe from the makers of FiLMiC Pro. You can quickly set your focus and exposure by tapping anywhere in the viewport. This will set an area of interest for both focus and exposure concurrently. If you want to lock your values, just tap the reticle so it turns yellow. Now it doesn't matter where in your scene you point your camera. The values will not automatically change until you unlock them. To unlock, just tap anywhere in the viewport to return to auto mode. At the heart of the Firstlight experience is cross swipe. The cross swipe gesture allows you to adjust both focus and exposure directly from the viewport without having to lift your finger. By default, simply swipe up and down to adjust your exposure manually, and left and right to adjust your focus. As you use cross swipe for complete manual control, responsive focus peaking is applied to ensure perfect focus, and zebras for perfect exposure. To aid you in achieving razor sharp focus, you can long press on the viewport to reveal the loop, which can be dragged anywhere around your frame. This used in combination with focus peaking will ensure proper focus even in the most challenging scenes. To hide the loop, just tap and hold it. When adjusting your exposure using cross swipe, red zebras will let you know that your highlights are clipping, and blue zebras indicate your shadows are being crushed. If you want to invert the focus and exposure swipe direction, just open Settings, Advanced, Cross Swipe Behavior, and select Expose Horizontally, Focus Vertically. To access Firstlight's basic settings menu, tap the cog icon. The configuration panel gives you quick access to the most commonly used photographic settings, including your shooting format, with support for DNG RAW, JPEG, HEIC, and TIFF. A countdown timer, allowing you to specify anywhere from 2 to 20 seconds, the ability to set your flash to off, auto, or on, a selection of framing grids, the ability to disable HDR, have it applied automatically, or enable it for all shots, as well as a wide range of supported aspect ratios. Beneath these settings, you get the ability to toggle on and off location tagging, show or hide the histogram, and enable or disable burst mode, as well as quick launch FiLMiC Pro if you want to capture cinematic video. In Firstlight, you can quickly select your lens by tapping the lens tray in the lower right of the viewport. Here you can access all lenses available on your device. On the iPhone 11 Pro, for example, you get access to the ultra-wide, the wide, the tele, and selfie cameras. FiLMiC Firstlight includes a selection of handcrafted film looks, vignette styles, and film grains that pay homage to timeless film stocks. To access Firstlight's film looks, tap the Looks button to reveal the tray. With the Looks icon selected, you can swipe through the different categories and tap the Info icon to get more information about the included film looks in each category, as well as swipe to preview them. Tap Outside to close the Info panel. With your categories selected, you can swipe through the available film looks, which are instantly applied to your live preview. Once you've selected your look, tap on the Vignette button. And here you can choose to apply a low, medium, or heavy vignette to your image in real time. Lastly, tap on the Grain button and choose between Fine, Moderate, Coarse, or ISO Adaptive Grain. ISO Adaptive will dynamically define your grain profile based on your ISO setting. I'm going to select Moderate, and now I can tap in the live preview to exit the Looks tray and take my photo. If you want to quickly reset your applied look, tap the Looks button, then press the Reset button located beneath the Info icon. Finally, an app that gives you classic film looks in camera without the need for heavy post workflows. FiLMiC Firstlight provides access to ISO and shutter priority modes, giving you the same experience found in high-end DSLR and mirrorless cameras. The priority mode selector is located in the lower left of the interface and by default is in AE, which stands for auto exposure. By swiping up, we can enter ISO priority mode. In this mode, you can swipe horizontally to set your desired ISO value. Now FiLMiC will automatically adjust your shutter speed value for you to ensure your shot is correctly exposed. This is great if you want to precisely control the level of noise present in your final shot. Swiping up again on the mode selector will let you enter shutter priority mode. Once selected, you can swipe horizontally to set your shutter speed and have FiLMiC automatically set your ISO for proper exposure. This opens up some really creative possibilities. If you want to freeze time, try a high shutter speed value. If you want silky motion blur, grab a tripod and try a very low shutter speed value. To return to AE mode, just swipe down on the priority mode selector. Capturing the perfect moment is easy with FiLMiC's burst mode. To enter it, tap to open settings and enable burst mode. Now, simply press and hold the shutter button to shoot a burst sequence. At the top of the interface, you'll see how many images are being captured. The beauty of FiLMiC's burst mode is that it works with filters too. Tap the looks button, apply a filter, and press and hold to take a burst sequence. FiLMiC also gives you control over just how fast your burst interval is. To adjust it, open Settings, Advanced, Burst Rate. Here you can select between low, normal, and high. By default, live analytics in the form of zebras for exposure and peaking for focus will be automatically applied whenever you use cross-swipe. However, they are fully customizable. Just tap Settings, Advanced, Analytics Colors. You can select your desired color and threshold for both shadow and highlight clipping. For example, I'm going to set my shadow clipping color to orange and then reduce the threshold from 12 IRE to 10. Now when I make a cross swipe exposure adjustment, you can see that the color and threshold change have taken effect. Under the Advanced Analytics menu, you can also disable zebras completely. If I tap to disable shadow clipping and return to the main viewport, you can see that zebras are only used for my highlights. Under the Analytics Colors menu, you also get full control over focus peaking color and intensity, and you might find that reducing the intensity can give you more fine-grained control over your focus. In the upper left of FiLMiC's interface is the Custom Function button, which allows you to map a custom function of your choosing for quick access. Simply tap and hold to reveal the function picker, and all the most useful options are available. I'll select Capture Format and tap outside the function picker to close. Now I can tap to cycle through all available capture formats from the main UI. If I tap and hold on the function button again, or select Burst Mode. Now I can quickly enable Burst Mode without having to open the Settings menu. Whatever feature you would find yourself most often diving into the settings to adjust, save some time and simply map it to the Custom Function button. FiLMiC has full support for 1.33x anamorphic lenses and will apply the D-squeeze at the time of capture, meaning there's no work required in post. With your anamorphic lens attached, just open Settings, Advanced, Anamorphic D-Squeeze, and turn it on. Now your image is D-Squeezed in both the preview and the final capture for truly breathtaking wide aspect photos. And if you find yourself regularly using an anamorphic lens, you can tap and hold on the Custom Function button and assign the anamorphic option to it, which will save you having to select it under the Settings menu. FiLMiC saves your photos directly to the native Photos app. To view them in FiLMiC, tap the Library button to reveal your last shot in full screen. You can swipe through your photos in the full screen view, as well as mark it as a favorite, delete it, or quickly share it. If you want to switch to a grid view to make browsing your library easier, tap the grid button and then scroll through your library and tap the image to open it full screen. At the top of the interface, you can either jump to the Photos app or tap the FirstLight icon to return to the camera. We hope this jumpstart tutorial gets you up and running with FirstLight. Please subscribe to our channel for more FirstLight and FiLMiC Pro tutorials. And if you have any questions, please let us know and we'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching.